It's a huge privilege, and we are extremely lucky to be able to have such a close relationship with the ocean and with nature, and sometimes be able to see wild animals in their own natural environment. Who else can do that? And we can do that every day we're sailing. You can pause with them.
sailing is my job. Most people just get like so crazy about their job that they need to take a vacation from it, right? But the weird thing is when I go on vacation, I go windsurfing.
It never gets boring.
Especially there are so many new maneuvers to do, there are so many new spots to check all around the world.
You don't have to be full aggro and aggressive to have a good time.
Everybody thinks you can't have fun unless it's 12 knots and you can plane. I don't think I planed for the first 3 years I sailed, and I had a hell of a lot of fun.
Here on Maui, you know, you get spoiled. Some guys won't even go out when it's only 3 foot. You know, they'll wait till 6 foot and above, and then it's time to go out. You're out there having fun, that's what counts. Now I know to think about soul, think about soul.
Every type is interesting. Everything is fun. It's just a combination of everything, and it's just windsurfing. When they ask me why, I never tell them where I've been. Their reaction might send me into a spin. Close my eyes, I'm never going back again. Change my to find a balance out of everything, and it's not possible to sail only in extreme conditions.
It's kind of a lost art, the whole freestyle thing. I mean, because there's such an emphasis on shortboards and jumping and looping and, you know, carving jibes and stuff, that nobody does freestyle anymore really for fun. And I get a kick out of it. And it was hard to get by.
Now that's balance.
There's supposed to be a balance, like study first and then go sailing, but I try to stick to that as much as possible, but sometimes you just gotta sail.
to me, it's the simplicity and the artisticness of it all. You know, just you go out there, it doesn't matter how you sail the wave, you know, it's your own thing. Every wave is different. That alone keeps me excited about it. I get kind of bored going back and forth on a slalom board. Every time I do that, I end up trying to, you know, do some loops or, you know, just do some freestyle on the slalom board. And wave sailing, I never get bored.
Aren't that many power sailors around. Yeah. Most of it's hooked into the harness and crews. If you took all the guys on the world tour, there's probably 10 guys that I'd say are full-on power sailors.
To me, still the best sailor in the world.
The guy totally goes off and has been going off for a hell of a long time.
He's an absolute idiot.
If I didn't windsurf, I'd race cars or motorcycles. Or... Here's Jason Policow. Oh! F***ing character. He's a good kid. He's a really good kid.
And Jason is like really one of the guys that come along and have really, with a really different style, some different maneuvers, you know, taking all the maneuvers that everybody else does and just does them a little bit better. And he's into it. And he's a young kid and he's going to be around a long time.
What a load of absolute bullshit. I'm pretty unprofessional, you know. I go out there and I'm so, you know, in a hurry to get out there, I never tie anything down. When I get out there, the mast track slides back, my boom drops down, my harness lines are too long. So that's why I look really uncoordinated in the water. You know, I'm sailing like this, so, you know, I've just got to practice slowing down on the beach, getting my equipment right.
So much techno garbage in this sport, it's ridiculous. But people think they gotta have the most expensive high-tech stuff to make it work.
What kind of mast do you have? What kind of stiffness do you have? What kind of sails are you gonna use? Do you have the latest in materials? I mean, it could be totally overwhelming to someone who just wants to do it, you know?
So many people would have so much more fun on simpler equipment, you know? Like old sweatback fins and longer boom sails and no camber inducers, and I bet they'd go faster and they'd have more fun if they didn't have all that stuff.
Got a lot of money and you're out there just buying whatever seems to be working the best, sometimes that won't help. You know, you got to be able to be used to your equipment. That's one of the most important things, is having your equipment dialed in for your own personal sailing style. You got to rig your stuff for the way you like to sail it. It doesn't matter how everybody else rigs it, as long as it's rigged right. Yeah, rig it to your right way. Just rig it and kill it.
Yeah, I love getting hit. I prefer to do the hitting, but once in a while you got to receive too. Looping a longboard is exactly the same as looping a shortboard, it's just a little slower.
I think you've got to get high enough out of the water so that when you start going around, the nose doesn't stick in the water and catapult you over the front.
Nah, that will never work. Doubles, triples, whatever. Something new has to be added into the sport. You gotta have the right conditions, so you need some real wind and a wave coming straight at you. And then it's just mind over matter and pitch it. Close your eyes and just go for it. 1.5 is what hurts the most. Once you make it, all the pain seems to go away.
Kids, don't try this at home.
You gotta just get crazy and go for it.
Kind of rounds it off, you know?
The sport doesn't exist by itself. What exists is the people who are windsurfing. So I really enjoy being able to be close to and be friends now with Robbie and everybody. It's a nice thing. You learn a lot from these people, and you don't learn only a lot about windsurfing, but you learn a lot about respect to the ocean, about understanding waves, understanding nature, about life in a general way, which is a lot more important than windsurfing.